Hello there, beautiful souls. This is Tahmid, and this video is about LTSpice, which is a schematic editor and also a circuit simulator. Now, first thing first, you should go to Google and search for linear technology. You should land into this page, and I'll also put the link in the description below so you can easily find it and then install it. And it's very easy to install, like many other Mac applications. Just copy the file into your application folder. Okay, now search for LTSpice and start a new blank schematic. Well, it should look like this. Make the window a little bit bigger and choose a view and grid dots. Let's do the wiring first. Right click, draft, wires, and you are recommended to do the wiring first too, because if you do the wiring first and then add the components, LTSpice will override them for you, so you don't have to like delay the wire or cut the wire and then add the component. So it's a neat feature from LTSpice. Okay, come on. All right, sorry. Oh yeah. And I mean, like, LTSpice is very much competent to do anything that, you know, like other simulating softwares like PSpice does. I mean, my instructors, they're using PSpice, and like LTSpice saved the day pretty much for me. And I hope it helped you too. Okay, let's add some components. Draft component. Now, to add those things with using the right click and then finding them, it's pretty time consuming. So I should, you know, like I'll use some shortcuts from now on. And don't worry, you can see them on the screen. Okay, let's add a diode. Well, right now I'm changing the orientation by pressing Ctrl R. Let's make it forward bias. Put it here. Let's by pressing function F2, I can add another component. Let's put a resistor here. Let's add a voltage source. This orientation, okay. Well, and we're pretty much done with our components. Now, well, another thing, you should always put the ground first. I mean, you need ground. It doesn't matter whatever you're doing, whatever circuit you're working on, but you will always need to put a ground. So to put a ground, you should wire first. Okay, let's put it here. Okay, that's fair enough. Okay, let's here. Label it. Okay, make it ground zero. Okay, yeah, we're done with ground. And the next thing we should do is define the input and output voltages. Let's label here. The out. Okay. Well, we also need to put the values here. Let's put a 10k resistor. Pick a diode for D1. Pick new diode, and you should choose the closest one that you did your experiments with in your laboratory. I'm using this one. Okay. Done. And let's choose a voltage source. Well, now the tricky part comes. Well, if you used, you know, like DC value, you can just completely, you know, like blatantly put a value here, but I'll put a sinusoidal voltage here. Sinusoidal AC input, so yeah, go there. Well, DC offset, make it zero. And let's take an amplitude of 5 and frequency of 1 kHz. Done. Okay. Well, you can see here that I did take AC sinusoidal input voltage. What else? Okay, I think we're pretty much done with our circuit. Let's run it. Well, now to run, you have to put analysis command, and the way you do it is go to draft and then spice to active. Well, if you don't know the command, then you're completely okay. You just can choose to get help from analysis command. Okay, now you can do transient analysis, AC analysis, DC sweep, I mean anything you want, but I'm gonna use transient now, and let's make a stop there for 2 milliseconds. Oh, done. You're okay to put it anywhere you want. Let's put it here. Well, now I hope everything is okay. Let's run it. Duh, I got it. Well, let's make the grid points and data points discernible, which is visible. Okay, grid and data points, done. Well, now let's check the input. Voila, we got it. And let's check the output. Cool, you can see that the negative portion of the circuit is clipped off. So, and if you just change the orientation of the diode, you can make it positive clipper circuit very easily. I mean, LTSpice makes it very easy for you, and all you need to do is to change the orientation, and you can do it easily by pressing function and F7 key and choose it and keep it here, and then change the orientation by pressing Ctrl R twice. Let's put it here. Okay, let's put it here, and you're done with that. Let's cut it and run it once again, and now you'll see it will be a positive clipper circuit. I mean, hopefully. Alright, again, let's choose the grid and data points on. Okay, we're done with the input and output. Well, you can see that now the positive portion is clipped off. Well, that's pretty much it from me, and I hope you're capable of doing any kind of circuits on your own on LTSpice. And if you face any sort of problem, then feel free to ask them in the comment section. I'll try to respond as soon as I can. Well, good luck and ciao!